To start. Now, what is this? What is this about? Now, let me try and integrate 1 over ax plus b. Everyone write down. But before I integrate, I need to convert to power. What's the power? Integrate what? So, integrate what? If I change this to power, this thing is power what? Die. Means I must put it to on top, right? Power minus 1. So ax plus b minus 1 dx. Now, based on the integration that I learned, my power must what? Plus 1 or minus 1?
Plus 1.
Plus 1. Plus 1, I got a problem. Why? I got 0, right? And worst thing, I divide by 0. Because I divide by new power. Then this one will end up in a very humongous error. So there is no way you can integrate if the power is minus 1. But if minus 2 can integrate?
Okay.
But minus 1 cannot. Now you understand why? So the usual step I do is I will follow this through. I will try and convert. I will integrate. I will see an error. I will be shocked. Then I will think of integration of ln. Now how did the ln come over? Now, can you copy this down? If I integrate ln fx, what do I do? Tell me. 1 over x? No. But this is fx. 1 over fx. So 1 over fx. Then what? Multiply by, differentiate the inside. Oh, forget already. I give example, if I differentiate ln 2x plus 1, what is the answer? Copy the inside, put it at the denominator. What is the top? 2. Can follow? Now, based on what you learned just now, if I know the differentiate, I will know the integrate. Why? Because if I integrate the right hand side, what do I get? I'll get the left hand side. Do you see it happening? I integrate the right hand side, I'll get back the left hand side. I integrate the right hand side, I get back the left hand side. Then plus C. Okay. Then Now, I integrate. Now let's say I integrate 1 over, everyone write down. I assume whatever I write, you copy as well. Now, when I integrate this, I need to prepare this. Prepare this so that it is the same as fx over f prime x over fx. So I look at this. If I differentiate the bottom, what do I get? 2, right? I get a 2.
But on top is only 1, right?
Now there's no way I can do a 1 plus 1 because 1 plus 1, then if I minus 1, it's not equal. Alright? So what I do is I need to
please show me the timer. Good. So I integrate 2x minus 1. Now instead of 1, it should be what?
2,
right? Because then I have the fx over f prime x over fx. But are they equal if I put a 2? No, right? Because how can 1 be equal to 2? Then what must I do outside? Put a half. Half and 2 will cancel to give you the 1. And because of this, then this one become half ln 2x minus 1 plus c. Just like that. Okay? Very tiring, huh? Listen to me talk. Non-stop. There's another school of thought. Another way of doing it is telling me if I integrate, then it will be divided by differentiate inside. Also possible. Okay?
I don't confuse you with different way of thinking. But if you have different way of thinking, it's okay. Unless you get, as long as you get the same answer, I'm okay. How does partial fraction do together? Can you look at example 7? And then write down, this one is what? Can you write down? Cannot what? Integrate what? Quotient rule. Now, if you cannot integrate quotient rule, what do you do? You split into partial fraction. Then you probably will win a Nobel Prize. Cause cannot ma. If you can, then. So partial fraction means what? This one, then I can split into two different parts. So can see, this one part can split into two different parts. So instead of writing one, I can split into two different parts. Then this is just log. Okay? So draw some boxes and let's move on. Okay. This one, is it easy now? Where does the 1 over a comes from? Differentiate the power. Is it a multiply id? Right. Okay, good. Move on. Okay, stop.